Hello students, in this video we will study about the armature reaction, its effects, remedies and MCQs. Now let's start. If I elaborate armature reaction into two lines, then armature reaction is the effect of magnetic flux set up by armature current upon the distribution of flux under the main pole. In short, as we know, there is a two types of winding is present in a generator. One is an field winding, which is present on a poles, and another one is an armature winding, which is wound on a armature or a rotor. Now when excitation is provided to the generator and a field winding carries current, the field winding produces fluxes which call armature main flux. This flux linked with an armature conductor, an EMF is induced in an armature conductor. Due to this EMF, a new current circulating in an armature conductor. And due to this current, the armature conductor also produce their own flux, which called armature flux. Now, the effect of this armature flux on a main flux called an armature reaction. Now, let's study in a detail. For a better understanding, I have divided armature reaction into three parts. Now, first one is an when field flux acting, when armature flux acting, and when both flux acting. Now let's first see first case, that is when field flux acting.
If my video helpful for you, then please subscribe the channel. Also press the bell icon for notification of new videos.
When field flux acting, and as we know, when a load is increased on a generator, the armature current also increase. That means armature current depend upon the load, and assume that there is no load connected to the generator. At that time the armature current is about to zero and only field winding carries the current. That's why the main flux produced by the field winding. As at that time, let's study on the diagram. Has this is an poles where the field winding is wounded. Here in a center, this is an armature where the armature winding are wounded. Now let's assume that the rotation of generator on this direction, the armature current is about to zero, only field winding carries flux current. Due to this current, the field winding produces fluxes which distributed symmetrically to the center line of the armature, and the direction of this field flux is from left to right. That means from north to south, as the main flux direction is shown in figure. Here the GNA and MNA is present to the center. Now what is a GNA and MNA? Now, GNA is nothing but geometrical net axis. That means GNA is the axis of symmetry between the poles. Here the GNA is nothing but this divided north and south pole equally with this center line, and in all the cases the GNA is always present in a center. It's noted that. Now let's MNA, that is magnetic neutral axis. The magnetic neutral axis is nothing but the axis along which there is no EMF induced in an armature conductor. That means, as we know from a Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, when a current is placed in a magnetic field, here the NS is a magnet which produces a magnetic field. When this conductor rotate or move, at that time only the field fluxes is cut by the conductor and EMF is induced in a conductor. That is measured by this galvanometer. In a similar way, and similarly, in armature, let armature rotate on this direction, and flux is distributed to the armature conductor on this direction. At that time, the conductor which rotate or move from one position to another position, only on that case the conductor EMF produce. The conductor which won't leave or move from their position EMF doesn't induce on it. Here, the green conductor indicate which leave their position or move or changing their position, and the axis here, this is a stable conductor location where the conductor is doesn't move or rotate. Hence, this is an axis called magnetic neutral axis where the EMF doesn't induced. Now, in this case, the MNA is present on a center line. Also noted that the MNA is always depend upon the field flux. The change, if the field flux change their direction, then MNA also change their position. Now let's toward the second point, that is when armature flux acting. In this case, only armature conductor carries current and field current is about to zero, and due to this only armature flux is present in a generator because of only armature conductor carries current. Hence, in a diagram here, the armature flux is shown. Now the conductor on left hand side of the armature carry current. This conductor combine their MMF to produce a flux throughout the armature in a downward direction. Similarly, the conductor on right hand side carry current, and the conductor also combine their MMF to produce flux on the downward direction. Hence, both conductor fluxes is sent in a downward direction. The direction is shown by this, air flies in downward direction. Now let's toward the third case, that is when both flux acting, and this occur when generator is on load. Now there is a two fluxes present, one produced by field conductor called main flux, another from armature conductor called armature flux. Due to these two fluxes opposition to each other, the main flux or field winding flux when entering in a armature is not only shifted but also distributed, which produce crowding of fluxes, that is increase in flux density upper tip of N pole and lower tip of S pole, and reduction in lower tip of N pole and upper tip of S pole. Here, as we know, the GNA is always present in a center, hence here also GNA is present in center, but the MNA is always depend upon the main field flux direction, so the MNA is shifted in this case. Due to non-linear behavior and saturation of core, the increase in flux in one pole tip is less than the decrease in flux in other pole tip. Consequently, the main pole flux is decreased. Hence, here the phi m is nothing but main flux and phi is nothing but armature flux. And due to armature reaction effect, the new flux, that is resultant flux, is generated. That's called phi r. And from the EMF equation, E is equal to K n phi, where n is a speed and f is phi is a flux. When load on a generator is increased, the armature current also increase. That means, as you know, the current is always depend upon the load, so load is increased, current also increase. Due to this increase in current, the main field flux or internal flux also increases in a generator. But due to increase in flux or armature reaction effect, there is a flux distortion occur and the main flux is decreases, and due to decrease in flux, the terminal voltage of a generator is reduced from this equation. Now let's toward the effect of armature reaction. The first effect of armature reaction is it reduces the generated EMF due to distortion or a reduction in flux that we just studied. Now second effect of armature reaction, it's problem in commutation or a sparking. And let's assume this is an armature. The blue indicate the conductors of a armature, and this is a conductor of armature. This is black is nothing but a brushes. At normally the brushes of a generator is present to the MN axis for a better commutation. Okay, but due to armature reaction, the MNF shifted, and hence sparking occurred between the axis where EMF doesn't induce. That means new MNA brushes. This will cause delay in commutation, also damage the brushes. Here the sparking are occurred. Now third is a flux weakening problem. It can easily understand by this diagram. The machine are constructed such a way that they operate near the saturation. By working near saturation means that the core is transferring flux near to its maximum capacity. The core would not be able to transfer more flux when saturation is reached. That means when saturation is reached, the core is not able to transfer more fluxes. At those location of pole surfaces where the armature MMF adds to flux pole MMF, only a small increase in flux occurred due to saturation. Here's the area where small increase in flux. However, at those location of pole surfaces where the rotor MMF subtracts from the field pole MMF, there is a large decrease in flux. Okay, since the decrease in flux is more than increase in flux, hence total flux is decreased and flux weakening is problem occurred. In a generator, flux weakening decrease power generated by generator, while in motor the speed is disturbed. Now let's toward the remedies of a armature reaction. Now first remedies is, for a small capacity of motors, the MNA shifting position constants. Hence we can adjust the position of brushes according to the MNA angle to avoid sparking at brushes. As we know, brushes is placed along with MNA, but due to armature reaction MNA is shifted. Hence we can set the position of brushes according to new MNA. Due to this, sparking is avoided. But for a large capacity of motors, the MNA shifting angle is dependent upon the load. Since load is varying, therefore it is not possible to change the position of carbon brushes every time the load changes. So another method to avoid sparking at brushes is used to teeny poles between the main poles. Here the diagram is shown where teeny poles are placed between the main poles. This is a teeny pole, which also called interpoles. Interpoles are used to avoid sparking in a commutation. Sparking occurs due to flux present in a commutating conductors or a MNA conductors. This teeny pole opposes the flux in a commutating wires. As a result, net flux in a commutating conductors becomes zero and sparking is neutralized, but flux weakening is still present. Now third, using compensating winding. Flux weakening is neutralized by installing compensating winding in the slots present in the pole faces. Here this is a diagram where compensating winding are shown. The winding produces flux which opposes armature flux, and hence armature reaction is neutralized. Compensating winding are connected in series with rotor winding so that its flux alters according to change in armature flux. Now let's toward the MCQs of armature reaction. In a DC generator, In order to reduce sparking at brushes, the self-induced EMF in a coil neutralized by all of the following except interpoles, dummy coils, compensating winding or shifting of axis of brushes. Now first pause the video and try to solve it. Now let's draw the answer. The answer of the given MCQ is answer B, that is dummy coil. As we study, interpoles, compensating winding and shifting of brushes are used to reduce sparking at brushes, but dummy coil are used to support or mechanical support to the rotor. Now let's draw the second MCQ. In a DC generator, the magnetic neutral axis coincides with the geometrical neutral axis when there is no load on the generator, the generator runs on the full load, the generator runs on overload, or the generator runs on design speed. Now first pause the video and try to solve it. Now start. The answer of a given MCQ is option A, that is when there is a no load on a generator, on this case only the GNA and MNA are coincide with each other. Now let's draw the third MCQ. The demagnetizing component of an armature reaction in a DC generator reduces generator EMF, increase armature speed, reduce interpole flux density, or result in a sparking trouble. Now first pause the video and try to solve it. Now let's draw the answer. The given MCQ's answer is option A, that is reduce generated EMF. The demagnetizing component of armature reaction in a DC generator reduces generator EMF. This is the end of this video. If my video helpful for you, then please like and share, subscribe the channel, and also press the bell icon for notification of new videos. And at the end, thanks for watching.